Hello there, AP World students. This is going to be my last topic for Unit 7, and it's all about genocides. This is going to be a relatively short lesson, but it is very, very important because genocide is a new concept that started during the 1900s. There were several genocides during this period. I'm going to highlight some special ones that the College Board really wants you to know. But you gotta know the concept of genocide. It's the deliberate killing of an ethnic group with the aim of extermination. And it largely has to do with the new inventions from the Industrial Revolution. Because before, it's actually quite challenging to exterminate people. People will run away, people will hide. But with these new technology, killing can happen in a much more methodical and much more efficient, much quicker way. So we'll see a whole lot of that in these examples to come. All right. So the first major genocide of this time period was the Armenian Genocide. And the Armenian Genocide took place during World War I, and it was done by the Ottoman Empire, specifically this group within the Ottoman Empire called the Young Turks. And the Young Turks, they sort of saw that the war was going badly for the Ottoman Empire, so they said, okay, well, when this war is over, we want to create a land for the Turks. And right now, the country that will one day become Turkey, there's all kinds of these Christian Armenian people living there. So the Young Turks decided to exterminate them. And the Ottomans really kept this under wraps as much as they could. There were many people around the world who didn't know this was happening, and it was only kind of revealed after the war when they were saying, like, hey, where'd all the Armenian people go? And they're like, oh, we don't know. And there's bones of Armenian people all over the place. And still to this day, the country of Turkey denies there was a genocide. The country of Turkey says, well, you know, we arrested some Armenians and we kicked them out, but we did not attempt to kill them all. Well, the Armenian people, on the other hand, claim that a million or more Armenians were executed around the country. And if you look at Turkey today, not a lot of Armenians are still in Turkey to this day. So clearly there was some really terrible stuff that occurred in the Ottoman Empire during World War I, and it was kind of the basis for the genocides to come later in this time period. But yeah, ultimately the purpose of this genocide was to clear out land that would become a nation state for only the Turks. All right, moving on. So this is the big genocide of this last 100 years, the Jewish genocide, which is commonly known as the Holocaust. The Jewish people have long been blamed for Europe's problems. I could go on at length about the history of anti-Semitism in Europe and how the Jewish people have been repeatedly persecuted all throughout history. But the Holocaust is undoubtedly the worst chapter in the history of the Jewish people. And the Jewish people, they've always been this minority group in so many parts of European society. They typically are wealthy. They typically are educated. They typically are in positions of power and politics. And so when Hitler rose to power, he could sort of easily point the finger of blame at the Jewish people in Germany. He especially blamed them for the loss of World War I. He blamed them for the Great Depression. He blamed them for the rise of socialism in the Soviet Union. Honestly, you name it. Hitler blamed the Jews for it. It really came down to that level of hatred. And during World War II, Hitler actually decided to take a good amount of his military resources, and he assigned soldiers that otherwise could have fought in the battlefields and trains that otherwise could have transported material to fight in the war. He said the bigger priority for the German people should be to exterminate the Jewish race so that they could, in his mind, never cause any other terrible things to happen in world history. And I've got some pictures here to show you. This is a box of wedding rings from people they killed at Auschwitz. And this is a famous memorial in Budapest, Hungary, because some Nazi guys, they got all the Jewish people in Budapest, they lined them up on this river, and they shot them and had their bodies go in the river. And here is the famous Gate of Auschwitz, This is the concentration camp where something like 2 million Jewish people were killed, mostly in gas chambers. And the statement there is in German, Arbeit macht frei. Work sets you free. But none of those people were intended to be set free. They were all intended to be worked to death. The gas chambers is really something else that is quite telling. It was this factory of murder. And no one had seen something like that before in world history. And it's so ironic that Hitler himself was a soldier in World War I who said that gas was a coward's weapon and that gas should never be used on a battlefield. But he signed off on using gas to exterminate the Jewish race. Well, half of all the Jewish people on planet Earth were exterminated, and as a result, to this day, the German people are so apologetic about this. I know that in German textbooks today, they totally acknowledge their role in the Holocaust. They acknowledge they did something wrong. And over the last couple 50 years or so, Germany has paid $3 billion as reparations to survivors. So Germany's at least trying to absolve for this event, but the Turks, they couldn't care less about the Armenians. So that's quite a different story there. All right, moving on. So here's some pictures related to the Holocaust. Here's some Jewish people getting rounded up, getting sent away to be exterminated. Today, the Auschwitz concentration camp is a museum. It's not a museum you kids should go to and take smiling pictures and post Instagram photos. There's always some kids that do that, and I'm like, what are you doing? This is a place where millions of people lost their lives. Show some respect. Yeah, there's the gas chamber. And if you look on the walls of the gas chamber, you'll actually see the scratch marks from people who are trying to escape and did not escape. So I think that's also quite telling of the horrors that the Nazis did to these people. Okay, the next genocide to talk about is probably one you kids haven't heard about. It's the Cambodian genocide. It has this kind of common name as the Killing Fields. And something very interesting happened in Cambodia in the 1970s. This very radical communist group known as the Khmer Rouge, they took over the country, and their interpretation of Karl Marx wasn't that they needed an industrial society to have communism. Their interpretation was they needed everybody to be equal, industry be damned, to have communism. They believed that all the people who were living in the cities, especially the big city of Phnom Penh in Cambodia, the people of Phnom Penh were corrupted with Western ideals and that those people basically couldn't be saved. The Khmer Rouge's dream of a perfect communist society was everybody's going to be a farmer and everybody's just going to treat each other equally as farmers. So they brought all these people out to the farms, and the people who refused to work, who didn't really participate effectively in the farmlands, they were taken out into these fields outside of some of the major cities and just exterminated en masse. 25% of the population of Cambodia was killed during this 3-year period. And the Khmer Rouge ended when Vietnam invaded the country in 1978. And when Vietnam invaded the country, they're like, hey, why are all these cities empty? And people were like, we were forced out by the Khmer Rouge. If we didn't leave, they'd kill us. And they killed many of us. So this one isn't really about religion. This one's about political ideals. And this was a socialist country that had just a very extreme version of communism that thankfully no other countries in the world have shared. But it's definitely a harsh lesson that some people say they want to bring equality to the people of their country, and by equality, it's going to be equal misery and suffering. Okay, and then the most recent one, the Rwandan genocide. And this one's also quite unique because it was a 2-month-long genocide. All those other ones I told you happened over the course of multiple years. But in Rwanda in 1994, a pretty unbelievable event happened. It was this civil war between these two tribal factions known as the Hutu and the Tutsi. And by all accounts, the Hutu people and the Tutsi people have lived in Rwanda for thousands of years. There's slight cultural differences between the two tribes. I mean, they speak the same language, generally have the same religion. Supposedly, you could maybe see some ethnic differences between Hutu and Tutsis, but the Tutsis were sort of treated as the superior group during the time of imperialism. And imperialism had ended in Rwanda for 20 years, but the tensions kind of kept boiling between these two groups. And in 1994, the Hutu president was assassinated. I think later we actually found out he was assassinated by this other Hutu faction. But when people heard the president died, local reporters went on the radio and said, oh, it was the Tutsi. The Tutsi killed our president. We've got to get revenge right now. And so the majority Hutu population, they got knives, they got machetes, they got really basic weapons, and they went all over the country, and every Tutsi person they could find, they killed. And so this one wasn't really done with industrial weapons or machine guns or gas chambers. This was neighbors killing neighbors. And in this two-month period, they killed almost 1 million people. It's really shocking that this got so out of control so quickly. Rwanda is still healing from this event even today. I know that the current administration in Rwanda is really trying to have some truth and reconciliation stuff, trying to promote Hutu and Tutsi unity, because this was just a terrible example for the world about how animosity and hatred between cultures can just very, very quickly spiral into a unbelievable amount of dead bodies. All right, that's it for this lesson, all about genocides. Hopefully you kids learn to do whatever you can do to make sure this kind of stuff never happens in the future again. All right, peace out.